they Jews? Didn't they have Jewish neshamas? Are they lost forever? Could a Jew ever be lost forever without having a tikkun? Even Eisai HaIsh, the founder of the Christian religion, the worst Jew, the best guy, even he will have a tikkun, the Ri HaKadosh says, after 50,000 yivelus. He will have his tikkun. He will come to his perfection. He was a Jew. No Jew can ever get lost. The Pasuk says, Levuti yidach mimenu nidach. No Jew will ever be cast away and rejected forever. Everyone will, in due time, have his aveiros wiped off, and he will come to Olam Haba. In the Gemara, which you are going to learn on Tisha B'Av, you will find that Unculus, when he wanted to become a Geyer, so the Gemara tells us that Unculus spoke to all the Neshamas. He interviewed the Neshamas of all the Rishayim, and he spoke to Titus and to Nebuchadnezzar and to all the other Rishayim, and he asked them, what about becoming a Jew? I want to become a Jew. Should I become a Jew? Should I convert to Judaism? They said no. And you should always try to trouble them, to make trouble for them. And then he interviewed Eisai HaIsh, he interviewed Yashke. And Yashke told him that you should become a Jew, and you should always try to do good things for the Jews. So the Maral in Netzach Yisrael says, because Yashke is a Jew, and when Unculus talked to him, he was already in a different world, not in Olam Hazeh anymore. And he has a shaychus to Olam Haba. He will come to Olam Haba. So therefore he was able to say good things about the Jews. But the others who were interviewed were Goyim, and they have no shaychus, they have no connection with Olam Haba. So even after their death, they're still as mischievous and as hateful to Jews as they were when they were alive. That's what the Maral says. Even Eisai HaIsh, even he will have a tikkun after 50,000 yevils. So why shouldn't Dasan Naviram have a tikkun? Why is the Ohr HaChaim HaKadosh so bitter against them? He says that they will never have a tikkun, and he finishes off talking about them, and he says, Kacha Yevdu Kal HaYevecha Hashem. So may all your enemies be lost, Hashem. Is there no tikkun? Is there no hope for Dasan and Aviram? They're Jews. Matsasi Kaifel. I found a redemption for them. Baruch Hashem, the Rabbeinu Shel Olam happened to make me aware of just opening a sefer, and that sefer is a sefer. It's called from the Ramami Pano. It's called Gilguli Neshamais. He speaks about the Neshamais, of what happens to them after life and what their tikkun would be, and he speaks about Dasan and Aviram, and he says that Dasan and Aviram did have a tikkun, and they're on the way to their tikkun. Dasan and Aviram were reincarnated, they were Megulgal, into the two oxen, the two animals, which Eliyahu HaNavi sacrificed on the Har HaKarmel, because he wanted to prove that there is a God, that the Jewish God is a God. When the Jews at that time worshipped under Ahab and Izebel, they worshipped the Avodah Zarah Baal, and he brought two oxen. One, and the understanding was, let's see who's the real God, the one that the fire will come down from heaven to that sacrifice, to that carbon. And Eliyahu HaNavi brought two oxen, one went for the Avodah Zarah, and one went for the Mizbeach of Hashem, which he built up on the Har HaCarmel, and the fire came down to the ox on the Har HaCarmel, and everybody proclaimed, Hashem Hu HaAleikim, Hashem Hu HaAleikim. So these were the two oxen, Dosan and Aviram. And that was the tikkun that they had through Eliyahu HaNavi. And they're on the way to the tikkun, because they were used for a good purpose. And perhaps this needs a little explanation. Dosan and Aviram didn't listen to the Navi, and they didn't listen to the mitzvahs of the Navi. They refused to keep the mitzvah of tzitzis. They refused to keep the mitzvah of mezuzah. You don't need mezuzah with the house, when the house is full of sfarim. You don't need tzitzis if the talis is full of treilis. They refused to listen to the Navi to do mitzvahs. Their tikkun was that they listened to the Navi, to Eliyahu HaNavi, when he told them to do an aveira. L'shem Shemayim. Because you're not supposed to bring any carbon except on the Beis HaMikdash. But there Eliyahu HaNavi, through the Tzivui of Hashem, Hayroas Sha'a, was makriv the carbon on the outside of the Beis HaMikdash, on the Har HaCarmel.